I've decided to do a video of an Amiga game next. I want to do Turrican 2, which I have as part of this box set. And actually, I did think about it a little bit as I was recording this video, that it does kind of cheapen it just a little bit by having these box sets instead of having single versions of the games. But I always choose this option because it's just a much cheaper way of getting a copy of a real game. And I do prefer to have a real copy of the real game to play on real hardware. But sometimes you end up with box sets like this that are a little bit ugly. But I do like opening it up and just seeing lots and lots of floppy disks inside. So that's always quite nice. I don't think I've even tried the other games, because I only really bought this for Turrican 2. And we have the Turrican 2 disc here, which is just on one floppy disk. And I'm quite surprised by that, because this game is quite a big game. There's quite a lot of stuff in there, and they've managed to squish it all onto one floppy disk. I do have this for the Commodore 64 as well, because this game was, as far as I understand, a Commodore 64 game that was made on the Amiga and the Commodore 64 side by side. So one of them's not a conversion of the other, but it is a Commodore 64 game by design. Of course, it's on a cassette tape on the Commodore 64. So I've set it up here, and yeah, it is a complete and total mess. But this is my Amiga. And in fact, this is a A1200 model. And it doesn't say that this is compatible with the A1200. But I think that's because this compilation came out before this model of Amiga came out. But that doesn't really matter. The game works. So, it does take a second to boot up, but let's play some Turrican 2. This game has a nice long intro with some really good music, but I think for the sake of the length of the video, I'm just going to have to cut most of it out. But it's definitely worth watching, and I'm sure there are other YouTubers that have uploaded the full intro, so do go and check that out. I'll show a little bit of it.
here we go. I go straight to the left here because there's a somewhat hidden block with lots of power-ups in it. Yeah, I want to get the laser. Out of the three main weapons, I prefer the laser because I think it's the most powerful. Look at that, loads of action, loads of enemies on screen. So one of the more unique things about Turrican 2, and to a lesser extent Turrican 1, is the really big expansive levels. You do get quite a lot of time to explore the levels, and it's well worth exploring them because there's often a hidden one-up if you go off the main route. But there is a time limit, so don't take too much time. It looks quite generous, but you can run out of time. Some of these levels are really big and mazy, so you can run out of time. Yeah, here's another one of these hidden blocks. So you can get a few different things from these. You can choose one of the different main weapons, of which there are three. So I think I have the most powerful laser right now. You can regain your power. You can regain your shield. You can pick up the power line attack. And I think you can get a temporary invincibility as well. This game really doesn't shy away from throwing loads of objects around on screen, and it runs at 60 frames per second as well, which is not a given on the Amiga, because although the Amiga is game-friendly hardware, I think it was built to be arcade hardware, actually, originally, or for a home console before it was turned into a computer. It's not quite as easy to make it run fast as the Japanese consoles like the Mega Drive and the Super Nintendo, but the Amiga is very flexible hardware, so you can do a lot with it. I've just picked up a few diamonds there. You can get extra lives from collecting diamonds as well, but again, you do have to look for them to a certain extent. And actually, I've got to say, I mean, this game is absolutely fantastic, and it's a classic Amiga game. But there are certain points, like this area I'm in now, where it doesn't really look very nice. I mean, I've got a completely black background here. And there are definitely better looking Amiga games out there, a better looking 16-bit games out there. So if there's anything that this game is lacking, then it is that sort of, that graphical wow factor. Or even, you know, something like Gunstar Heroes, where it just throws such a sheer amount of stuff at you constantly that it just, it kind of blows you away. This is a game that's more like an 8 or a 9 out of 10 instead of a 10 out of 10. But that does mean that it's still a very, very good game. Oh, another one up. Well, unfortunately, I accidentally go back quite far. So I've gone right back to the start of the level now. Although, thankfully, all the enemies that I've killed stay dead. Interestingly, Turrican 2 wasn't converted to all that many other 16-bit machines. It was converted to the Atari ST. It found its way to the PC, I think, a bit later. And it was on 8-bit machines like the Commodore 64 and the Amstrad and the Spectrum. But it didn't make its way to the Mega Drive or the Super Nintendo properly. Alright, so that's the first level boss, although that's not the end of the level. For some reason you fight that first boss about two-thirds of the way through the level. Oh god, don't kill me. I was panicking a little bit there. The game was going to be ported to the Mega Drive, but it ended up getting a movie license attached to it, and it became Universal Soldier. But compared to this version of the game, that one is so ugly that I don't even want to think about it. But this game is, by design, a Commodore 64 game. And this version for the Amiga isn't a conversion of the Commodore 64 game. It's sort of like it was designed for the Commodore 64, but then they made two versions at the same time for the Amiga and the Commodore 64. And this version of the game is much, much better than the Commodore 64 version. And actually, it's quite remarkable that they've squeezed so much game onto one floppy disk. I am really running out of time here, so I need to get to the end quick. With 3 seconds to spare. I think there's five worlds and each of them has two areas. A lot of the criticisms that people have for this game seem to be based around it being too easy. And I suppose it can be quite easy if you can rack up lots of extra lives. But I don't find it easy, because getting through these really long levels does take a little bit of effort. Each level seems to have its own music. I need to apologise for talking over the music so much. But, you know, I do add narration to my videos, so sorry, but that's just how it is. So whereas something like the Mega Drive has just got two layers built in, and then it has dozens and dozens of sprites, and everything is kind of tile-based, just to be memory efficient, the Amiga is completely different. So it's got something called bit planes, and you can have up to 5 bit planes, which is just like a separate area of memory. And you can use those bit planes in a variety of different ways. One of the ways you can use those bit planes is by having 2 different scrolling layers, but then you're limited to 8 colours for the background and 8 colours for the foreground. I think Turrican 2 seems to use it in such a way where it displays the most colours that it can display. So I think it's displaying 32 colours at once, and maybe the sprites have their own colours. Not in this area I'm in now, but in other areas you can see that kind of gradient background. And that's a way that they can sort of have a separate background without actually having a different background, by just using the, I don't know what it is, I don't know if it's the blitter or the copper, but it changes the background colour every line. That became a bit of a standard thing for the Amiga, to have nice colourful gradient backgrounds. It's not like a programming trick. It is just a programming feature of the hardware. I find all this stuff really interesting, but I don't always understand it. Oh God, stop bombing me. How am I supposed to avoid all that? If I get it just right, there's a secret area down here. So yeah, Turrican 2, it's... if you buy an Amiga, this is definitely one of the games that you should get for it. Or at least one of the games you should play on it. Here's the second boss. This one's a bit trickier than the first one. He spits out these guys, but you can't jump on them. The normal versions of those you can jump on. And I think they're the only enemies that you can jump on for some reason. Oh, that nearly killed me. That was a bit jammy. So now we're on to World 2. So actually there is a Turrican game that I do have for the Mega Drive, and that is Mega Turrican. And that's a game that was made from the ground up for the Mega Drive, but it ended up getting converted to the Amiga later as Turrican 3. But that's a little bit different to this one because it's a little bit more of a graphical showcase with like rotating sprites and all sorts of graphical effects. But it's a bit different because it doesn't have big expansive levels for you to explore. So I think a lot of people prefer Turrican 2 over Turrican 3. Maybe I should do that next for my next video. I have absolutely no idea which direction I'm supposed to go to get to the end now. You can sort of see the criticism I had earlier about the graphics not being like a 10 out of 10. But you can see the background here is just like the same thing over and over again. So, I mean, it's the pixel art is very good, but it does look very tiled. But I mean, that's a small criticism, really. This is the end of the video. Once again, thank you for watching. Goodbye.